I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to make two mini gift boxes. I used a milk carton die that I have in my stash, but you can also use a template to make a box like this. Just do a quick search on the internet. So first I'm going to do all the folding. I first fold it in the opposite direction. Here the red is going to be the outside. This way you stretch the paper a bit so you make a bit more room for the fold. And then I use my bone folder to burnish. By the way, I added the products I used in the description box for you, and if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe! I cut little panels for the red box and I measured the space and made them a bit smaller. First I distressed the edges and then I'm going to tape them in place. I fold the paper so I can see better where they need to go. And then I tape the box together. Then I start folding the top. I have a little clothespin that I decorated with the paper to close the box. Now you can leave the bottom open if you want to pre-make some boxes so you have a bunch on hand. I will finish the boxes so you can see the end result. The box closes like this with the opposite flaps first and then the other two flaps. I will lay the box flat and tape one on the inside top and one on the inside bottom. And close the flaps without the tape and then one over the other and then press a little. Then turn the box over and use something long to rub on the bottom inside the box. You can leave it like this, but I'll add something more. I have Stick It, it's an adhesive sheet and it's really thin, and I have my piece of paper and I cut a piece of the sheet to fit the paper. I will add the sheet to the paper and then burnish so it sticks really well. And then I run it through the machine. I use the craft pick to get the snowflakes out of the die. These snowflakes are from the Winter Wishes set. I have a piece of the backing of the adhesive sheet that I will use, so don't throw that away. I will peel off the backing paper and then I will add some glitter. I sprinkle on the glitter and then press it on the snowflakes with the leftover paper. By the way, if you feel inspired, I always love to see you make, so don't forget to use hashtag GerrisCraftroom when you share your work on social media. For the other flakes, I use gold glitter. Now I will add them to the boxes and I look which side I like best, and then I can glue them in place. I've made some dots with jewel drops and glitter accents. Glitter accents aren't really meant to make drops, but if you push them a bit in shape, it will work. I pre-made them on a piece of backing of double-sided adhesive, and this way you get a bit more control, especially with a bigger project or on a project that isn't flat, so it's easier with drying. I use the jewel drops as a glue to add the drops. The jewel drops dry clear, so it's good to use the same color. So these are my two boxes. It's a really fast project and will also work great as a gift for birthdays and such. I hope you liked the video, so don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching!